Sir, typically an operating system is an interface between the user and the system.
Yeah, that is true. So would you go to the lower level and could you please explain what it does? Yeah, that is true. It is an interface between user and that one, and in a lower level. So further, can you extend your
With
answer?
respect to this particular this thing, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. So for instance, in a real time this thing, real time operating system, what would happen is there are let us consider an electric vehicle, sir.
Okay.
So electric vehicle would have a lot of input coming, and it has to make decisions based on the input that is coming.
True, true, true.
So in this kind of a scenario, the input for the vehicle will come from the sensors like radar, lidar, camera, etc.
Okay.
So it has to have a operating system that will enable it to process these things as it is happening.
Yeah. So now, why can't you handle that particular thing with a simple program?
It will not be fast enough, sir, because the decision-making process on even if you take something like Python or C, it may not be fast enough to give immediate this thing. Because in a electric vehicle, for example, or an autonomous vehicle, if it is traveling in a straight line and suddenly
Okay.
some sort of obstruction comes, then it has to immediately make that decision to stop.
Yeah, now I think as a counter, see, if you have an operating system, you are creating one more layer which introduces more time latency. So in that sense, the time increases. You are further introducing some delays. Will you accept that delays? I mean, if you directly put your own program, it is faster compared to keeping it in on top of the operating system, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
But I feel that using a real-time operating system, instead of creating a separate program altogether, you're
Yeah.
integrating a system such that the program itself, that is the operating system itself, will analyze and put out the data without going through a lot of loops as such.
Yeah. So yes. So I mean, it is correct partially. There is some mistakes in your argument. I'll just tell you. And one more, Aniket is telling it manages hardware and software and provides a common services for the program. I mean, is it possible to elaborate, Aniket? I think you are almost there. Aniket, would you like to elaborate? I mean, you made a good, very good statement. It manages hardware, software, and provides the common services for the program. Aniket, would you like to come online? Yeah, I'll just give, I mean, support Ashwin's answer. See, he is telling electric vehicle, he took it as example, so rather than putting simple program, you want to use RTOS. Now I'll tell you the reason for this particular real-time operating system. See, operating system is also program. Okay, so operating system is also program. Nowadays, what is happening in electric vehicle, many components are coming, as a hardware. You understood. So there is some, motherboard is also present. Okay, so some ECU is also present. Lot of inputs are coming to that particular board, and lot of that means lot of hardware is getting connected to this particular, board. Now the thing is, every sensor, every hardware functionality is different. Now more and more hardware is getting connected, and more different types of software is required to execute that particular task. Now the problem here is handling those hardware and software is the issue. Okay, so when I have to execute which program is the question mark. Okay, so just to increase the overall performance of the electric vehicle, which program you have to execute and which hardware should be given priority. So all these things are issue in the electric vehicle. So the same problem is there in all the systems. So whatever system you consider, it may be any generic. So it may be computer, it may be any specific application, like it may be substation, it may be home automation system. So in all these places, more hardwares are there to manage, and more softwares are getting in. So to handle all these things, somebody is required. Okay, Earlier, what people were doing, they used to have some kind of sequential, pipelining concept to execute the program. Okay, so at that particular time, some priority task may be, coming at the end. So that should not happen. So there should be somebody who, direct, who monitors all the process, all the services, all the hardware in any given application. So that's why this particular real-time operating system is, is kicked up. You understood? So any clarity is required on this real-time operating system? I am telling this operating system is specific to application. Whenever we say real-time operating system, it is not a generic operating system. Okay, so unlike our operating system like Windows or Ubuntu or something like that, so it is not the generic operating system. The real-time operating system, is specific to some application. Am I clear on this? So it's like a microcontroller and microprocessor. Microprocessor is generic and microcontroller is specific, application specific. Similarly, the operating system, okay, so what you're using like Windows, Ubuntu or Linux or Mac, everything is basically generic, whereas real-time operating system is specific in nature. Okay, so now the thing is, it is highly required that, whenever you are executing, I want to make a smart meter. So you cannot write a sequential program. So when you make a smart meter, hundreds of programs will come into picture. Okay, so hundreds of functions you have to introduce. Each function is like a service. So all those services should, run in the back end. So in that sense, what happens? Many services are there. Somebody should be there to manage all the services so that overall performance and, control and monitoring, task will become easier. You understood? So in that sense, if you create a good energy meter, smart meter or something like that, instead of, keeping a single program, okay, it is better to execute on top of the real-time operating system. You got it?
Sir, I understand this, but one question I had in this regard was, yes. How does one, for example, if I want to, like you said, smart meter, sir, so it will not be easy to, for example, if I'm creating something innovative, it may not already exist, that real-time operating system for the particular service I want. So for every this thing, an individual will have to create their own real-time OS.
Yes, your argument is correct. So in that regard, so there are already available generic real-time operating systems are available in market. What you have to do, you have to take that generic real-time operating system, and what you have to do, you have to tune that particular operating system. You have to build from scratch and you have to create your own operating system for your specific application. So that kind of, thing is available in the market. So that means real-time operating system is also available in market for robot, some generic application. So real-time operating system is also available in market. The only one advantage I'll tell you, when you consider any operating system like my Windows, so in backend, lot of services are running, you may be knowing. Okay, so why I want to run all the services? When they prepare this particular Windows operating system or any Ubuntu operating system, they'll make sure that it has to work for all kind of hardware. For that, what they will do, they will run all kind of services in the backend so that it will suitable for that particular hardware. In that sense, it is completely time latency is high and unnecessary services are running in the backend. So in that sense, it won't become real time. So if I want my application or the software platform to be real time, then what I have to do, I just have to suppress all the unnecessary services in my application. So that is what the real time operating system does. Okay, so we have to select the real time operating system. And say, for example, it is specific to the hardware. So this real time operating system will sit on top of the microprocessor and microcontroller, and then you just implement and you just create your own function and you just run, then it will become real time is just avoiding unnecessary latency in generic operating system. Am I correct,
sir?
Yeah,
sir. One doubt there, sir.
Yes.
If ultimately the goal is to just reduce the number of background processes, what if systems like DOS or Unix, Ubuntu and such, where you can limit the tasks that are happening in the background, if those kind of operating systems were used, wouldn't it be a lot more easier because you won't have to create an operating system from scratch?
Yeah. I mean, you see, in that regard, okay, I'll just tell you one thing. Say, for example, I'll just show you, say, for example, okay, so this one. Okay, I don't know whether you might have heard of this particular operating system.
Gentoo,
I think you might have worked on this. See, now now I already told, you see, operating system, they will build the binary and they will give it that some 4GB binaries, they will give it and you just have to run. I mean, the compatibility is maybe 4, 8, 7 out of 10, 7, 8, it swings in that particular value. I mean, 100% compatibility will not be there. So now what you have to do in this Gentoo, what happens, they will download the compiler. And I mean, if you install from the stage one or stage three, okay, you will be downloading some 30 MB data compiler, and you are going to create a compiler itself for your hardware first. Then you will delete the old compiler using that new compiler, which is 100% compatible to your machine. You are going to fetch all the libraries and you will create an operating system. Can you imagine? Then that means what? Your operating system is 100% compatible with your hardware. Okay, so this kind of options are there in especially in this particular operating system Gentoo. You can create an operating system from scratch, which is completely compatible to your system. And you see, some simulations may take 5 days, 10 days. But when you create this kind of operating system, you can execute those programs within some hours. 1,000 times time latency decreases when you create this kind of operating system. Okay, so again, this is Gentoo is basically creation of that generic operating system. Okay, so from scratch. So what I'm telling, we are talking about application specific operating system. In that regard, we definitely required to reduce all the, the latencies, time latencies, and that particular software should work in line to the, real time. That means whatever the real time, okay, time space is there. So in line to that, our program should work. So if that is the case, so we have to go for real time operating system. Got some idea about this operating system?
Yes, sir. But sir, I think like one issue that can come up with this kind of a system is that sometimes you will require to link multiple operating systems, sir. Like, for example, if you take the Tesla cars, so now they have one very nice user interface for the individual who's driving the car. And I am pretty sure that they will also have a separate, operating system for the internal functions of the car, like automating of the sensors and all of that.
Yes.
So the linking of those two operating systems will have to be another headache, no, sir?
Yeah, see, now the thing is, linking the operating system is it works with your hardware. Linking is basically, communication. So one operating system, other operating system, how you're communicating. Now the thing is, in general, nowadays, whatever operating systems are coming, most of the time they will make sure that, that portability is there. Say, for example, I write a Python program in Ubuntu, the same program will run in Windows, the same program will run in other platform. So in this kind of portability, they are ensuring. Okay, so if you ensure that thing, then I think, any operating system you can build, you can run anything. That's why if you see the Linux distribution, you don't know, thousands of Linux distributions are there. Linux operating system is there, thousands of Linux operating systems are there. So in that, some are very popular, Ubuntu or, some operating system, but thousands of operating system, how those operating system came, they just try to build their own operating system. Okay, so in that sense, when you want to make an operating system for electric vehicle, definitely you have to create from the scratch, and that will definitely can communicate with other electric vehicle, other real time operating system, whatever which is there in other thing. That's what when you see any electric vehicle, no normal car only you take, you console, that console itself is a real time operating system, So you have a ECU, a car ECU, that console is directly connected to your ECU. Okay, you understood. That is also a real-time operating system. Okay, so every car has a console. So you can, that console, whatever console we have in our car, that is not an operating system, right? So that won't look like an operating system. But if you see in a minute sense, that is an operating system. That is, connecting to many parameter in a car, and it is displaying, it is having some multimedia operation, it is having some security aspect, it does lot of functions. Okay, a lot of services are running in that particular, console. So you can imagine the real-time operating system there. So when you take the electric vehicle, we required some more robust, operating system. So it is not a simple console. So some other, since everything is electrical, everything is signal, and some more robust operating system is required. So that's why, working on this real-time operating system for electric vehicle is also a very good scope in future. So that means, you are telling, completely you are managing all the functions in the electric vehicle. Similarly, it works in the robot also. Your robotic operating system is there, ROS, they'll call it as ROS, okay, robotic operating system. Okay, so all these things comes under a real-time operating system. Am I correct? You understood the overview of this?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Understood.
Yeah. So try to work on this real-time operating system. Okay, so there is some opportunities will be created in future. And also, whenever you are working on the for example, whenever you work on the electric vehicle, normally people will take a Raspberry Pi and they will write some program to do something, say maybe some SOC measurement controlling the motor and all those things. Now what you have to do, whatever hardware it is available in the electric vehicle, you have to create, for example, Ubuntu inside you have installed some kind of, Raspberry Pi you might have installed Raspbian operating system. So instead of that, you should come up with your own, operating system, so that, you can create a market for that particular operating system in future. So people will really appreciate. So that problem will definitely come. So we cannot run the sequential programs in the electric vehicle. So operating system definitely required. That must be a real-time operating system. Okay, so it's just, lot of things are there now. Now that's what I want to ask question. What this operating system does, that is what I want. I want from your end. See, for example, this Windows you are running, what this Windows does? So anybody? Anybody in the class? Yusuf, can you come online? Can you tell me what this operating system does?
Yes, sir. You want me to explain normal operating system?
Yeah, normal operating system. Okay, operating system.
Operating system is just a set of programs that are designed for the operating of the system, of any system.
Yes, yes. They call it as a kernel, okay. The set of programs, in some other places, they'll call it as system functions. Okay, there will be some system calls. You will be using that particular system calls to interact with that particular, functions, and you can connect with the different hardware in your machine, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Any other functions this operating system gives you? Any other person, you can also put it in the chat box. Yes, Vikram is telling it translates the command to machine language. You understood. Okay, there are many programs are there which is which you have to interpret. Okay, so you may be having some script. That script has to be translated to machine code and it has to run. You understood. So you will be having some kind of runtime environment in the operating system which take care of that particular translation. Okay, converting that particular high level language to machine level language. So you will be having some just-in compilers in your operating system that will take care of that particular work. Very good. Very good, Vikram. Any point you want to make, you can put it in the chat box. What the normal operating system does. So if you understand normal operating system, we just have to map that particular task to the real-time operating system. That's all. You know how you have to understand there will be one main program and all other programs are kept in different places in a memory. You understood. So it is something called you have a main program and you are calling the subroutines. So that is how they will create a operating system. Okay, so that is what real-time operating system in the basic sense. Yeah, any other task the operating system does? I mean, this kind of questions you can expect in the interview also. Whenever you sit for interview, okay, so normally if you're opting for IT companies, okay, so they will ask this kind of question. Okay, tell me about operating system. What are the functions this operating system does? So this kind of questions they will ask. So you should be in a position to coin some good, points. Then definitely, they will appreciate and, they will give you some, opportunity to work there. See, normally when you see, it's some kind of, microcontroller, microprocessor level you have to think. See, your operating system is taking care of input-output operation, correct? Okay, so I have a display, okay, this touch screen, I have a keyboard in my laptop. Okay, this operating system is taking care of that particular thing, okay? It is managing all the input-output operations in my system, correct? One. Okay, and the second one is what it is doing. It is managing memory, okay? Don't you think? So it is managing memory. What is that memory? Okay, I have a hard drive, I have a SSD, I have RAM, I have different types of memory in my system. So all the things it is communicating and so required data, it is, it is making sure that all those data is available in appropriate places. So that means memory management it is doing. Okay, so the second task. And the third and most important point in operating system is basically scheduling. Okay, scheduling. So all the tasks are scheduled in our operating system. Okay, so when which program should execute, all those things are scheduled. Okay, so say for example, when I keep USB pen drive, so when it has to detect, that is also defined. Okay, so say for example, when notification should come. Okay, so when the operating system should diagnose the hardware. So all those things. So all those things are defined, okay, scheduled in the operating system. So if you see the, say for example, if any services has to stop and start. So all those things are defined in the back end. So you can see the services, list in any operating system to see how those tasks are scheduled. So scheduler is one more important aspect in the operating system. Okay, and also the hardware management or resource management is the major task which will be done by your operating system. Resource management means what? You have so many things are connected. You have an Ethernet port, you have a USB port, you may be having some graphics driver. Okay, so you may be having lot of peripherals are connected to your system. So all those peripherals are nothing but it is connected to different devices. It may be connected to printer, it may be connected to some internet, it may be connected to some other machine. So all those resources, so your operating system manages. So resource management, memory management, scheduling, okay, and IO management. So all these things are a major task done by your operating system. Okay, so you understood this four points. Any doubts in these 4 points? IO management, resource management, scheduling, okay, and memory management. So these are the major work of your operating system. Yeah, any clarification required? Okay. So now how we have to take up this particular real-time operating system? Now you know, okay, these 4 things. IO management. When we take real-time operating system, say electric vehicle, don't you think the input outputs are coming in real time in electric vehicle? Yes. So definitely we have to incorporate lot of IO operations as a services in our system. Okay, so IO management we have to do. And also, don't you think lot of data is coming in, and it has to go somewhere, and it has to effectively, it has to fetch and it has to load in a memory. So load and store operation should be there in that particular system. Yeah, so memory management should be there. And the third one is scheduling. Okay, so I already told you the complexity. Okay, the electric vehicle is more complex system. It's not it won't does a single task, it does many task. So in that sense, what you should know, so the complete scheduling is required. Okay, so priority task, okay, so non-priority task, okay, so this kind of things one should take care. So that is basically real-time operating system. And the last one, what I told, resource management definitely. Say there may be lot of diagnostic input output from different system is coming, different devices are there, so it just has to diagnose every time, it has to test itself, and so along with this, all this operation, this all this diagnostic things should independently happen in the back end. So all these things are basically resource management. You understood? So these things we have to connect to the real time operating system, and we just have to build. Okay, so now how we can implement this particular real time operating system using microcontroller, that is what we have to take up in the next class. Okay, so implementation of real time operating system, okay, so using microcontroller is what we have to take up in the next class. Is that clear now? It's quick processing. Yes. So any doubts at this particular point? Yeah. Explore this operating system. I think normally electrical students are not that explored to this particular operating system. So please work on this operating systems. At least if you are not working on real-time operating system, at least work on Linux. Definitely, that will be useful for you if you go for IT sector, or even if you work on the electrical application. This Linux operating system knowledge will be definitely helpful to you. So start exploring this operating system, especially Linux. Okay, so don't explore Windows. There is nothing to explore. Okay, everything is freezed. So now you just have to see the Linux machine. Okay, and take up any one distribution and start working on that. You will definitely gain a good knowledge. Okay, so then you can definitely work on different RTOS or in anything. So don't simply just imagine some one program you are written and which is running and which is fulfilling your requirement. That is not the way to work. Okay, so your program should sit, and which has to be called by some other agent, that agent being your operating system. Okay, so in that way you just have to think. Okay, so just to explore this, and the next class we will continue with microcontroller and real time operating system. Will that be fine? Shall we close today?